Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani, and today I'm talking lip filler. And one of the most common questions we get asked is, how long does it last? And is there a permanent solution? This would be, in fact, great if we had a solution that was safe, long-term, and gave great results over time. So I want to go through the options with you today. A lot of people say, why do we use hyaluronic acid fillers in the lip if they go away in 3 months, 8 months, sometimes they can last a year, year and a half, but they reduce with movement, so they don't last forever. The reason is the lip area is dynamic, it's ever-changing, and the smile is closely associated with results. As an example, some people have a good lip, but when they smile, it goes away. So if there was a bad result or an untoward result or a lump or a bump from a permanent product, it's there for a long time, but also it's noticeable because of the dynamics of the lower face. We're just starting to understand all the dynamics and how the muscle movement plays a role in aging along with collagen loss. So let's go through the options. Hyaluronic acid we've covered before, that's our go-to product. Now, if we go to long-term products, people ask about Belafil. Well, the risk of nodules for me is too high. Some people say 1 in 10, maybe 1 in 30 or 40. Still, if you get a bump or lump, it's a surgical removal. So I personally don't use Belafil in the lips. It's a great product for other areas, just not in the lips. Our patients from overseas, they get things like bioalkamid or silicon, and some people in this country also use silicon. Bioalkamid I'd stay away from for the lips. Silicon, however, here is not a bad option. I don't use it. The keys are using a micro droplet technique and slowly developing the shape and never overdoing. But remember, you're always going to have that shape in your lip. You can't change it, and it's near impossible to remove once it's in. But I think overall, if someone's looking for a permanent solution, willing to take on those risks, that may be the best option, because the last one I'm going to talk about is implants, and they exist. Many of my patients who get them aren't totally satisfied, or at some point they have them removed. And that tells me for the majority of people, it's probably not a great solution. We do have Plasma Lip, also at plasmalip.com. We've had a lot of people ask about that. And remember, that's using PRF or platelet-rich fibrin. You get a lot of volume to start, but the goal here is to help the fillers work better, or as a standalone to help the fat improve, to increase vascularity, to get better color. But it's not going to give a large fill to a lip. It's an adjunct or a way to get a natural rejuvenation of the lip. And of course, you can add microneedling and other treatments with those products. So that's the story on lip filler. I think the bottom line takeaway is hyaluronics are still our go-to product. Add a little bit of neuromodulator like Botox and Dysport to help with shape, and do them over time. Don't let the lip filler go all the way gone before refilling. So do a little bit over time to get what you want and the great result that you'll be happy with for years to come, and not have to have anything untoward removed or an unsightly bump or lump. Thanks for joining me today. Click like below if you like the video. Subscribe for continued helpful tips. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.